every peacemaker to transform or to take into that project each and every peace lover of the society, to convert them into peacemakers and distribute the valuable message of peace in the society by maintaining the same. So, peace dialogue may be possible and effective only if the persons are peace oriented. For those other people who cannot understand the language of peace and white flag, then the language must be in the form of war and essential mechanism may be a military mechanism. So, as it has been clearly told in Bhagavad Gita about the varieties of society, those who can be terrorized and threatened by a defense mechanism, that is okay. And those who are rashes and impotent to come for war, then we have to speak with war. And those who are ready for peace and those who are right-minded, we have to take the initiative of peace. But by defense, by war and by peace initiatives, we want to establish that shanti, 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 indoor, shanti, different shanti. So many natural factors and so many artificial factors, with their imbalance, with their equilibrium, they result in ashanti, peacelessness. So, prithivi shanti, if earth lacks of peace, then it comes in the form of earthquakes. Then vanaspati shanti, forest fire, tsunami, there are various types of such abnormalities in the natural system mechanism. So, we want peace, and with the help of the unseen guiding spirit, the imperceptible divinity, taking that as a supporting and additive force, with all of our might, courage, distribution of knowledge, distribution of instrumentalization of our principles for the society to make the peace to be practical and effective, we have to do that. And to breathe that, there are only two principles which made this exhortation as it has been founded by our ancestors. One is the power of love, and second is the love for power, they used to say. And the power of love unifies everything and we can arrive at peace. And the love for power, either it may be religious, regional, ethnic or whatever may be the background, if there is a love for power, love for domination, love for trampling on other sides to be thrown, then it results in the perpetual cycle of miseries, perpetual cycle of total annihilation the society with its values. Let us hope and pray for this awareness in the society. For example, you see, if you have organized a ritual, a homa, or a pilgrimage to pass here in the temple, I could have got a better number of audience. And moreover, the number of audience are lesser than the number of visitors to my place. People, they resort to religion because of their qualities and justification of their rest and interest of awareness and fear. Awareness to get more benefits and fear of their mistakes. So everybody resort to religion. Whenever the sector that comes to intellectual exposure and exploration, the people are very limited. This irresponsible and irresponsive society must be nurtured and nourished with proper knowledge. Not by asking them to come before us, but by approaching the society, coming down to the level, translation of these things, distribution of these things in the form of any materials to educate them in the field of knowledge. For example, whatever he has told, the chief guest, if the audience here who breathe, digest, assimilate, understand and apply with the basic knowledge of what he has spoken, the country will get a battalion of valuable soldiers who are more valuable, precious, efficacious and hyper potential than even the battalion soldiers. And so to a right path, to a right place, just as good seeds have to be sown in a fertile soil, that there is proper manure, irrigation and fencing, this thing must be the exact audience, the effective audience of the society, and it is not a single day thing. See, construction mechanism is not a single day work, because it is a deep-rooted menace that exists in society over thousands of years, centuries, millennia. So it takes lot of people, lot of institutions, lot of seminars, and lot of campaigns, a lot of awareness institutions have to be established. They must be made with educational syllabus, apart from the other advanced things that are put in these competitions and in examinations, which are not going to serve the practical purpose of the person's patriotism and development of a nation. Such things like ethical leadership, the national security, the citizenship values, the history, the Holocaust, see, the destruction of a nation. There are two things which can bring spirit to the citizens to become a patriot. One, the pride of the past and the laws of the present. How glorious we were, that must be shown to the people, to the students. And what is our present position? I am saying that there must be a boiling in the blood. There must be some sort of a dynamic outburst, explosion, which must turn into tactical unification, resulting in the real goal and achievement of our institution, not only our institution, the government institution as well as any other institution which is maintained for, which is meant for and maintained for the welfare of the society. Let us hope and pray. The choice of blessings of the ultimate spirit, the cosmic being near, and the super cosmic designer, and the ubiquitous, omniscient, all-pervading personality of Godhead to shower his choices, blessings, to extend the longevity, to give them physical, psychological, intellectual, and spiritual progress for all the participants and concerned persons of this society, as well as this subject, as well as this team and institution, to get into the relentless task of unifying like-minded people in rectification of the society, which is that deeply overwhelming negligence, ignorance, and subservience to create a unified global relationship and fraternity. Narayana. Even though they are like-minded, they are of single opinion, frequency of meeting, integrity and commitment. If two people who are in the process of destroying the nation meet together, they will forget about themselves and they will think about destruction. But two people, knowledgeable people, meet together in constructive process, they will forget about constructive process and think about themselves, about personal mutual egoism and priority and preferences. So, why it is so? Because negativity has inbuilt power. Because it is everywhere. You know that small insects, as they are ephemeral in nature, their productivity, their expansion, growth, everything will be swifter than the other organisms. Why? Because they are ephemeral. Eternal organisms, that too, intellectual evolution of human beings also exists with physical growth, so everything. But negativity is very powerful. Not only because that it is powerful, it has limited power, but the power is distributed within a limited span of time. The RPM level is more because it is ephemeral, it has to execute and exhaust the whole RPM level within the lifespan. That is the greatness of negativity. That's why we used to say even practice, vairagya, sadhaka, sadhaka, you can say asura sadhaka, not deva sadhaka. Now, the person is very ardent, a vehement practitioner, we used to say asura sadhaka, he has done asura sadhaka. Not devata. So, because it is assumed in nature, so let you be divine in heart. But in your action, be assumic. Again, be assumic person. If the forces are assumic, you will be hyper assumic, ultra assumic, be a way. So, this is the problem between the positive forces, lack of continuity, integrity, fidelity, and commitment. These are all various other things essential for the quality leadership, which can take this into pathway. So, I have thought about two things. One is the lineage of guidance, the perpetual lineage of guidance. If I give you good guidance, people are so potentially stamped by the other extra scriptural benefits and graces. I am not going to give. That is the difference between a preceptor, philosopher and a preacher. The preacher gives you only this book. He used to say, there are three nyayas. One is Bhikshuka Nyaya, Atithi Nyaya and Sukha Nyaya. So the Atithi, the guest is also asking for food.